Okay, just a small update here. What is very good for the WP Alliance is we are still seeing some new member. So the health of the WP Alliance is good. Okay. And this shows also the interest of the industry. With no funds to the new member, I just would like to cite here Microsoft. We have been in difficult time having no software company in the WP Alliance, and now we are very glad to see that people like Google, Microsoft are now the WP member alliance, so this is very good for our corporation. Okay. And also to notice is that we have more and more company from Asia, a lot of company from China now we are in the WP Alliance, so this is very good. And I do believe that we'll have to go in China for a meeting with the WP Alliance sometime next year or in 2 years' time. You have certainly read some mails for doing a call for a new promoter. Okay, so we have been reviewing some candidates for the promoter seat, and I'm very glad to welcome Toshiba as a new promoter. Okay, so this is Ariel. What is very good? I'm sure a lot of people know Ariel. Okay. They have been very contributive in WP Alliance since the beginning. And what's good for the board also is that Ariel has been very proactive in a lot of working group. Okay, so also we have seen he's young, he's very dynamic. So we are all expecting to get new idea coming to the board. So welcome, Ariel. All the board is very satisfied to get you on board. Thank you very much.
Toshiba
also. Okay. Good health of the alliance is to see also new specification. You know, we are not living on what we have done years ago, but we are creating new ones. Okay. Just to name few of them. You have on first the analog control interface that we have been created recently. What is interesting, this is the first analog interface. Okay, if you look at all the specifications for MIPIAT, all of them are digital interface. This one is going to be analog control interface. Second one is BIF, the battery interface that has been released recently. Good thing also is that we have already done interoperability on BIF, which was very successful. And normally this week we should have a press release on the BIF. I'm not going to go through all of them. What is very nice to see that there is a lot of them. And as usual, the debug working group is very productive. And it's good to know that not only they are productive, but we do use these specifications, so this is very good for us. Since now, I would say 2 years, there has been a lot of question, requirement from our members to go for improving the number of testing and debugging stuff for the specification that we were delivering. And since last year, we have been working in that way, okay? And if you look here, this is some documentation that has been produced by the different working groups toward improving the testing of the specification. Okay, so you have the BIF, you have camera, you have FFE, and UniPro that has been delivering some documentation for helping our member to test the interface. Okay. And this helps also to go for interoperability and be successful very early in the development. You have seen that WP Alliance tried to be not alone in the industry. We are doing some cooperation with some other organizations. As of today, we have done an MOU with the GDEC that has produced the UFS specification for the flash server interface. UFS is already at revision 1.1. I believe there will be a press release this week. Okay, so they are happy with the specification. We have done an MOU to deliver the M5 to the GDEX, so they are doing UFS on top of M5. Following this GDEX MOU, we did an MOU with the USBIF. So what are they doing? They are doing the USB 3 over the M5, okay? Which this interface is called SSIC, Super Speed Internship. And the good thing is that they have released the specification. So this is one more success of cooperation with other organizations. We have UFS and we have now SSIC. To mention, there is some tutorial today. If you want to know more about this SSIC, you'll be able to follow this tutorial. If you look at now, we have more than 200 members. Okay, I believe somewhere 220, 230 members. And we don't know always our members, you know, like you say, know your family. And I think it's time for us to understand what is our ecosystem. Okay? What are the companies that are making BPLEs? Do we have all the companies needed to be successful in the area we are going after? Camera and display, we know that we have been successful, we have delivered specification. Do we need other companies to go after something else? For example, LFFE, SLEMers, or deliver new specification, for example, for sensors. Okay? So we have started, we have initiated a survey. Okay, we are subcontracting this survey to IPNest. Okay, and they are going to define what is our ecosystem. So please, they are doing this survey from the information they can get on BPV member website. So normally, I would advise you to go to the website and see how you are defined. So your company, you can say, I am IP provider, I am semiconductor, whatsoever. And if you want to provide more information for this survey, do not hesitate to contact Marcia or see with her. So you know Marcia, okay? And so to help to better define what will be in the survey to define our ecosystem. We will make available the outcome of this survey to all members, because it's good also for you to understand the companies that are in BPLEs, and also to alert the board if we are missing some company in the BPLEs to be successful. Just like I explained you, so they will collect the information from your website. Okay, so nothing will be confidential data whatsoever, okay? We will just collect public information. So if you are able to have this ecosystem survey, please do it, okay? I think that will be a very good marketing tool for the BPLEs and even for the members to go after this. You might have seen recently that there has been some change in the technical steering group. Dirk Hoffmann, after doing a very good job, he has been handling the TG for some time, asked to change. He was not able to continue, so we are sad to lose him because he was doing a great job. At the same time, we are very happy to welcome Rick. I don't know if you know Rick. So we have Rick Whitfield that has been elected to chair the technical steering group. He has done his first day yesterday as the chairman, and we are fully confident that TSG will be driven very well through Rick. Good to know that the TSG is more and more consolidated our roadmap, the vision of BPLEs for what do we do next. And I believe Rick will show you the roadmap from the TSG, and it's good also for you to understand where we go, and also to find out, is there any gap within our roadmap? So it's a role also of the TSG to do this. At the same time, we are going to change maybe a little bit the technical steering group participation to have more fellow architects to participate, to contribute. So soon we will do a call for participation in the TG for this, okay? And so we will work with Rick and the board to define how we better empower the technical steering group for going after a new specification for the BP Alliance. First outcome this year from the TG, not the only one, but we are going to go after a sensor investigation group or bird feather. This needs to be discussed today at the board, but this is the first outcome of the TSG process.